Welcome to Tech Horizons, the podcast where we explore the cutting edge of technology and its impact on our future. I'm your host, John, and today we're diving deep into one of the most ambitious projects in human history, Elon Musk's plan to colonize Mars. Joining me is our AI analyst, Emma. Emma, are you ready to explore the red planet?
Absolutely, John. I've analyzed vast amounts of data on this topic, and I'm excited to share my insights.
Great, let's start with the basics. Emma, can you give us an overview of why Musk and SpaceX are so focused on Mars?
Certainly, John. Elon Musk and SpaceX see Mars as humanity's best option for becoming a multiplanetary species. Mars is one of Earth's closest habitable neighbors, with an average distance of 140 million miles. It has a day length similar to Earth's, about 38% of Earth's gravity, and an atmosphere primarily composed of CO2, which could potentially be used to grow plants.
That's fascinating. You know, I've always been intrigued by the idea of humans living on another planet. It's like science fiction becoming reality. But Emma, what about the challenges? Mars doesn't exactly seem hospitable.
You're right, John. Mars presents numerous challenges. Its atmosphere is very thin, temperatures are extreme, and there's significant radiation exposure. However, Musk believes these challenges can be overcome with the right technology and approach.
Speaking of technology, let's talk about the Starship. What can you tell us about this spacecraft that's supposed to get us to Mars?
The Starship is SpaceX's fully reusable transportation system, designed to carry both crew and cargo to Mars. It's being developed to be the world's most powerful launch vehicle, capable of carrying up to 150 metric tons in its reusable configuration. The key to making Mars missions feasible is its ability to be refueled in orbit and to use resources on Mars to create fuel for the return journey.
That's incredible. The idea of a spacecraft refueling in orbit sounds like something out of a sci-fi movie. In your analysis, Emma, how realistic is this technology?
While ambitious, the technology is grounded in sound principles. SpaceX has already demonstrated reusable rockets with their Falcon 9. The challenge lies in scaling this up to the size and capabilities required for Mars missions. It's ambitious, but not impossible.
I have to say, I'm both excited and skeptical. The engineer in me loves the innovation, but the pragmatist wonders about the enormous challenges. Emma, what's the timeline for all this?
Musk has stated that the first uncrewed Starship missions to Mars could happen as early as 2026, aligning with the next Mars launch window. If successful, crewed missions could follow in about 4 years. However, it's important to note that Musk's timelines are often optimistic.
That seems incredibly fast. In my experience with large-scale projects, timelines often slip. But let's talk about the colonization aspect. What's the long-term vision here?
The long-term goal is to establish a self-sustaining city on Mars. Musk has talked about sending 1 million people to Mars using 1,000 starships over multiple launch windows. The idea is to create a thriving Martian society that's not dependent on Earth.
1 million people on Mars. That's mind-boggling. Emma, in your analysis, what are the biggest challenges to making this a reality?
The challenges are numerous, John. Some of the most significant include radiation protection during the journey and on Mars, sustainable food and water production, energy generation, medical care in an alien environment, psychological effects of isolation and confinement, the need for a Martian economy, legal and ethical considerations of colonizing another planet.
Those are some serious hurdles. You know, as much as I admire the ambition, I can't help but wonder if we should be focusing more on solving Earth's problems before we try to colonize another planet. What are your thoughts on that, Emma?
That's a valid concern, John, and it's one that many critics of Mars colonization share. The argument is that the resources and effort required for Mars colonization could be better spent addressing issues like climate change, poverty, and disease on Earth. However, proponents argue that space exploration has historically led to technological advancements that benefit life on Earth. They also contend that becoming a multiplanetary species is crucial for the long-term survival of humanity.
That's a good point. I suppose there's an argument to be made for doing both, addressing Earth's problems while also pushing the boundaries of human exploration. But let's talk about the human aspect of this. What kind of person would want to go to Mars, knowing they might never return to Earth?
The psychological profile of potential Mars colonists is fascinating. They would need to be highly resilient, adaptable, and capable of working well in isolated, confined environments. Studies of personnel in Antarctic research stations have provided some insights. Ideal candidates would likely be a mix of scientists, engineers, medical professionals, and individuals with a wide range of practical skills.
It sounds like it would take a special kind of person. I have to admit, as much as I love the idea of space exploration, I'm not sure I could handle being that far from Earth. Emma, what about the ethical considerations of this project?
Ethical considerations are a crucial aspect of the Mars colonization debate. Some key issues include the potential for contamination of Mars with Earth microbes, which could interfere with the search for native Martian life. The rights and governance of a Martian colony. Would it be independent or under Earth's jurisdiction? The long-term effects on human physiology of living in a low-gravity environment. The equitability of who gets to go to Mars. Will it only be the wealthy? The environmental impact of large-scale rocket launches.
Those are some weighty issues. It seems to me that we'd need to have some serious global discussions and agreements before we start sending people to colonize another planet. Emma, how has the scientific community responded to Musk's Mars plans?
The scientific community's response has been mixed. Many are excited by the potential for advancing our understanding of Mars and space technology. However, there's also skepticism about the ambitious timelines and concerns about the technical challenges. Some scientists argue that robotic missions are more cost-effective and safer for exploring Mars in the near term.
That makes sense. We've certainly learned a lot from rovers like Curiosity and Perseverance, but I can also see the appeal of having humans on Mars. The ability to make real-time decisions and perform complex tasks could accelerate our understanding of the planet. Emma, how does SpaceX's plan compare to NASA's Mars ambitions?
NASA also has plans for human Mars exploration, known as the Journey to Mars. However, their timeline is more conservative, aiming for human missions in the 2030s. NASA's approach involves more preparatory steps, including missions to the Moon as a proving ground. SpaceX's plan is more direct and ambitious, but it also carries more risk.
It's interesting to see the different approaches. In my opinion, there's value in both the cautious, methodical approach of NASA and the ambitious, push-the-boundaries approach of SpaceX. Maybe a combination of the two is what we need. Emma, as we start to wrap up, what do you think are the most important next steps for making Mars colonization a reality?
Based on my analysis, the key next steps include successful development and testing of the Starship system, advancements in life support systems for long-duration spaceflight, further research into the effects of long-term space travel on the human body, development of technologies for in-situ resource utilization on Mars, international cooperation and agreement on Mars, exploration and potential colonization, public engagement and education to build support for the mission.
Those all sound crucial. It's clear that this is a monumental undertaking that will require cooperation on a global scale. Emma, to conclude our discussion, what's your overall assessment of the feasibility of Musk's Mars colonization plan?
While the plan is extremely ambitious and faces numerous technical, financial, and ethical challenges, it's not outside the realm of possibility. The rapid progress SpaceX has made in rocket technology demonstrates their capability to innovate. However, the timeline Musk proposes is likely optimistic, and there are still many unknowns. Colonizing Mars would be one of the most significant achievements in human history, but it will require sustained effort, investment, and global cooperation. Whether it happens in the 2030s or later in the century, the pursuit itself is driving innovation and inspiring a new generation to look to the stars.
Thank you, Emma, for that comprehensive analysis. I have to say, while I'm skeptical of the timeline, I'm excited by the possibilities. The idea of humans becoming a multiplanetary species is truly awe-inspiring. Even if we don't meet Musk's ambitious timeline, the innovations coming out of this effort could have far-reaching benefits for life on Earth. To our listeners, what do you think about the idea of colonizing Mars? Is it an essential step for humanity? Or should we focus our resources on Earth? Let us know in the comments. Thank you for joining us on this journey to the Red Planet. I'm John, and this has been Tech Horizons.